Let me show you what we've been dealing with all day long. It's cloud cover. Not a lot of moisture with these clouds, just a few spits and sprinkles, especially the farther east that you live. When you look at this clouds map, it may look all the same to you. But to me, the brighter white clouds are the thicker clouds, or the clouds that may be producing a little bit more sprinkle activity or drizzle. But notice these darker shaded clouds towards the north and the west. Those are clouds that are beginning to thin out. And I think slowly but surely, as we're heading through the next 24 hours, we'll transition from cloudy skies for the first half of your weekend to more sunshine as we're heading into your Sunday. For the short term, though, the clouds will be with us. Drizzle, especially on the east side of town. Can't rule out a few sprinkles, but most of your evening plans tonight look to stay dry with readings comfortable in the lower 60s. As we're heading into the overnight hours, upper 40s, so we really aren't going to cool off much tonight. Now, dense fog is certainly possible. Again, farther east is where we'll see the better chances. The visibility could be close to zero for some as we head into the overnight hours tonight. Now, let's talk about your Sunday. And again, we could start off with some fog, especially on the east side of town in the morning with 48 degrees. But as we head towards lunchtime tomorrow, I think most of us will already be quickly clearing out. We'll see mostly sunny skies at noon, lots of sunshine tomorrow afternoon, 69 degrees. Our forecast high here in Kansas City for tomorrow, the record is 70, so we will be awfully close to record setting in terms of heat as we're heading through the second half of your weekend. You can expect 66 in Chillicothe tomorrow, 68 in St. Joe, 70 in Belton, and lower 70s for Butler and Clinton. You can enjoy these warm temperatures tonight and tomorrow. As we head towards Monday and Monday night, things will begin to change. Notice Monday will still be plenty warm with a high of 70 degrees, but as we head towards Tuesday and Wednesday, we will see those temperatures quickly dropping off back to highs in the 50s, but even these numbers are still a good 10 degrees above normal for this time of year. Here's a look at that 7-day forecast. And as that cold front approaches our area on Monday, we could see an isolated shower or two late afternoon and evening. Notice, though, it's really going to take quite a while here for those temperatures to settle back into the 40s, which is actually where we should be for this time of year. Right now, that looks to happen towards the end of that 7-day forecast for Friday and Saturday of next week.